Hey folks, in this video you're gonna learn how to use Freehand tool, a nice tool which helps you to create shapes and draw strokes freely. Also, I'm gonna introduce you a new tool called Hide Edge. Let's get right into it. To select the Freehand tool, you have to click on here and the shortcut is F. Using this tool, you can draw a stroke. By holding down the Alt and drag to the right and left, you can adjust the size of your brush and then you can draw your stroke. Like this. If you hold down the control and hold your mouse on the shape, you can see its path. And now by dragging on the points, I can delete them like this. Let me delete the rest of them. If you're using a pen tablet, you can go to Freehand options and check use pen pressure. And that way with more pressure, you can have more width. If you don't use one, it doesn't matter which one you check. Also, using random option, it adds some variation to the width of the line when you draw, and you can change the amount of variation using this option. So let me change it to 10, and now we have less variation than before. Let me hit Ctrl Z twice. Then we have taper start and taper end. Using taper start, you can start with lower width like this, and using taper end, you can have less width at the end of your drawing, like this. You can change the amount of it by typing the value here. For example, I type 0 now and draw. And you can see that we have less width here. Another cool thing is that you can actually increase this value to something like more than 100. For example, I type 200. And if I draw, we can end our drawing with more width. Let me delete all of them. The next option is smoothing. Let me move the marker to the left by dragging on it and uncheck this option. And now I draw something. You can see that this stroke is not very smooth. We can have a smoother strokes using this option. If you move this marker to the right and try to draw, you can see that this upper line is much, much smoother than this one. If I hold down the control and hold my mouse on the path, I can see the points. One important thing is that the more points you have, the harder it's going to be for the software to handle the project. To draw your shapes with less points, you can click on here and increase this value. It should be between 0 and 100. So I type 100 and draw my shape. If I hold down the control, you can see that it only have 3 points. If you already have a line like this, you can reduce the number of points by going to Select Point tool and selecting the points like this. And now if I click on Simplify, I can reduce the amount of points without changing the actual shape. You can change the amount of simplifying by clicking on here and type the value like 100 and then click on Simplify. Let's hit Ctrl A to select all of the points and delete. And go back to Freehand tool. I'm gonna check the auto-weld and uncheck these two options. And now if I draw something like this, I can have a shape with fill. Let me hit Ctrl Z. This time let's check trim start. If I start from here and end here, you can see that it's gonna actually trim the start of it, or you can check this and trim the start of it and the end of it like this. So these two are actually related to this one. If you uncheck this option, you can see that these two turn gray. And now if I check this one, I can close this line and complete my shape without releasing the click, like this. Let me hit Ctrl Z again and uncheck this one. This time I'm gonna check this option and draw a stroke. If I release the click here, you can see that the shape is completed and we also have a path here. But we don't have a stroke. There is a tool called Hide Edge, and using this tool, you can hide edges or showing them like this. Let's go back to Freehand tool and remove this shape by holding down the control. And to close your shape with complete stroke, you have to uncheck this option and draw your shape. Release the click wherever you want, and now it's completed. You know about these two options, This one is going to automatically add fill to your shape after you close it. And this one is going to automatically add a stroke to your shape after you finish your drawing. So now it's time to talk about merge strokes. I'm going to delete this shape by holding down the control, like this. Before I start my drawing, I'm going to reset the freehand options by clicking on here. And also I'm going to uncheck this option. And now it's time to draw two separated lines, like this. If I hit Q to select the select shape tool, and click on one of them, like this, you can see that it's actually one shape. So they can't have different colors. Every time you change the color of a stroke, it changes the other ones too. To avoid this problem, let me hit Ctrl Z, let me delete these lines, and go back to freehand tool. You have to uncheck this option. And now if I draw some separated lines, like this, and hit Q, you can see that we can change their colors separately. And that's it, guys. If you want to see more tutorials like this, don't forget to subscribe, and see you in the next video.